Jeez.
Who was that? Someone should go and see. Now.
Understood. treasures in caves like this?
Do you even know how dangerous cave diving is?
I go diving all the time. It can't be that different.
Eso.
To be back then.
I bet yours was too. You just don't know it.
You don't know her. She's the sweetest old lady in the world. I bet she's never even been in the same room as a gun. Bless her soul.
All right. Maybe just ask her about it next time you see her. That's all I'm saying.
Ten likes. Bullshit.
really putting it away, isn't he?
Yeah, hey, bro.
How many glasses does that make?
They'll cut them off if he takes it too far. Probably.
Find out what that was.
That's affirmative.
Great.
Sweet. How do you operate it?
I'm a bit of a grease monkey in my spare time.
Not my area, friend. The control terminal is up in the security room.
Thank you.
I'm wicked smart, and yet I find myself in these situations all the time, just... I don't know. How am I gonna tell my dad that I... I like the Yankees. Oh my gosh, this is difficult.
PTSD, huh?
You know,
you buy it?
It's not unreasonable. Think about it. Duvall was kidnapped by the militia and held hostage for weeks. He was forced at gunpoint to disclose the existence of Providence in a public broadcast. And those animals would probably have executed him like they did Thomas Cross if our security team hadn't broken him free. I would need therapy.
So, Duvall survives just long enough to retract his statement, appoint a Providence-backed successor as CEO of Ether, and then he accidentally slips in his bathtub during an anxiety attack?
It's odd, but I don't deny it.
Hey,
take God.
How are you?
Now, he's gotten it into his head that the partners are all somehow dead, and that the Constant runs Providence in their place. Conspiratorial thinking is a rabbit hole, my friend.
But if they murdered him, Duvall was a rat, but he had no choice.
He did. Just not a very attractive one.
Someone, please!
Thank you.
Corvo, got a message from the boss. Duty calls.
Let me guess, the Burnwood woman.
That's right. Yates has arranged for the chief winemaker to take Burnwood and Tamara Vidal on a grand tour of the estate. Wants you to tag along.
Not for my sparkling personality. This Burnwood woman sure has his panties in a twist. Wonder what the deal is.
Yates' business is his business. Just get yourself ready and sign into the visitor center. Oh, have a drink on my behalf.
I don't drink. It makes me sentimental.
A private tour of the estate. Diana, Vidal, and this fixer, Corvo Black. Black is a threat, but also an opportunity. Yates' own machinations are inconsequential. Joining the tour will give access to Vidal, away from the crowd.
Thank you for your service, sir.
Nothing quite spoils a party like your guests inexplicably dropping dead. Who were they again?
Couple of old money scions. Ingram and something Dutch sounding. I bet Sheikh Al-Ghazali was the real target. Everyone knows the family funds terrorism.
It's a nice gesture, but a bit hubristic, wouldn't you say? He's not even been appointed yet.
Caution and modesty has never been Don Yates' style. Did you see the wine list?
I'm more of a beer man myself, but if Yates wants to bring the Heralds closer together and play the modern boss, I don't actually mind. Edward's always worth it.
Hey, who is throwing stuff around here? Come on!
Friends killed Yamazaki, Cassidy, probably Bronson. How is she fit to be a herald? But on the other hand, people defect all the time, and she's most certainly qualified.
True. The Constant knows what he's doing. Doesn't mean we have to play.
No, they were discreet about it.
I caught a glimpse of a body bag, but that's about it.
It was only when someone realized that the elevators had stopped working that the work.
Hello there, and welcome to the Yates Winery. How may I help you?
Corvo Black. I'm on the tour.
Right, Mr. Black. Welcome. Miss Burnwood and Miss Vidal will meet you down by the wine fields. I trust you know the way?
I can find my way around.
Enjoy the tour.
One of the most gifted surveillance specialists ever to graduate from Kent. Ran one of our interrogation hack sites for a while, and I tell you, those prisoners fought like dogs.
ask me, the Constant must have lost his mind. Burnwood was in league with Grey. She's responsible for killing how many of our people? How could she be a herald?
Maybe Vidal will trip her down the stairs. Those heels are an accident.
Just don't hold your breath. Vidal is a true believer, fiercely loyal to the Constant. It must be why he chose her. Show Burnwood the road.
Over here!
You two must be Burnwood and Vidal.
And you must be Yates's garbage man. Sorry, but I didn't catch your name.
This is Corvo Black, Tamara. He's a ICA regular.
I only work with the best.
Well, we're all here, it seems. Except for our guide, the chief winemaker. Looks like we're stuck here until someone fetches him. Mr. Black, I'm looking in your direction.
Hold on. I'll track him down.
Attaboy. Do try and bring him back in one piece. Counterintuitive as that may be.
That was a bit rude.
Yes. Yes, it was.
I know more things. What happened? They broke it off. Ah, I never liked him anyway.
What is it now? What?
You have some guests waiting. Senor Yates wanted you to give them the grand tour, remember?
As if I don't have more important things to do than babysit Yates' socialite friends. It's only harvest season.
Better do what he says, Patron. Big shot in your lawyer like that.
Excuse me?
Well, I'm not going anywhere until I have decided to talk to you. Bring me the three of our best friends.
Mm-hmm.
Just put down
the crowbar. You hear me?
What the hell was that noise?
Diego's planning to go to Spain. So much for lucky number 43.
Ah, screw you.
Mr. Vargas, I have the three grapes you requested.
Yes, good. Bring him here. Now, let's see. No, inky black color. Good sight. Not in term. Brown. Thank you.
will do.
These are busy times. In fact, we're just about to harvest this year's crop.
Hey.
Great expectations. So how do you like Argentina?
Like everywhere else. Full of Americans.
First stop on the tour is the production floor, where our prize-winning Malbec grapes are processed. We insist on steaming every grape by hand, which means that during harvest season, the grapes do tend to pile up. Luckily, we have plenty of storage space. Our equipment is state-of-the-art, including an industrial-sized freezer unit, and last but not least, our trusty grape crusher.
Interesting. Wouldn't you say, Mr. Black?
Follow me, please.
Whatever.
Are you a wine man, Black? Somehow you don't seem the type.
Oh, I believe Mr. Black here is something of a jack-of-all-trades. Isn't that so?
I dabble.
I see. I just thought Yates might be sending a message. My mistake. So, have any of you
been to our media before? Only on business.
Next on our tour is the fermentation atrium, where the wine goes to its primary stage of fermentation. In these big open tanks, yeast converts the sugars in the wine to alcohol, in a process that lasts between 5 and 15 days. This is also where we squeeze the mass into a fine juice using our grape presser before the longer secondary stage of fermentation.
Fascinating.
Now, before we move on, do any of you have questions?
How about...
I have a question. It's... perhaps we can take a closer look.
Certainly. Lead the way.
What can you tell me about this device? Grape presser, was it?
That is correct, senor. After primary fermentation, the mass is pressed through a fine filter, leaving only the flesh and skins behind. I should add that grape stomping, the iconic practice of crushing grapes with your bare feet, is historically rare and mostly a tourist gimmick. But you are most welcome to try. Imagine you're a grape.
Thanks. I'll pass.
Oh, go on. I'll take a picture of the three of you.
Oh, come on, Tamara. When in Rome?
Fine.
You there! Excuse me!
Look at him. Does that face ring any bells? Alarm bells, for sure, but other than that, I don't know.
I know you can hear me. Don't push me. I'm...
The mass is pressed through a fine filter, leaving only the flesh and skins behind. I should add that grape stomping, the iconic practice of crushing grapes with your bare feet, is historically rare and mostly a tourist gimmick. But you are most welcome to try. Imagine you're a grape.
Thanks. I'll pass.
Oh, go on. I'll take a picture of the three of you.
Oh, come on, Tamara. When in Rome?
Fine.
Say queso.
May I see that, Mr. Vargas? I believe I blinked.
So, this is what the little guy feels like.
Nope, all good. Looks like one for the mantle.
Anything else you wish to know? What happened to your colleague?
Urgent call. Something about work. I don't think she'll be coming back.
Oh, well. I'm sure she can find her way out. Let's proceed. Excelente. So let's continue to...
It's a puddle either. We're talking knee-deep. The whole place looked like a horror flick. Of course, Yates came down and told the sod in charge of the tanks a new one.
You'd think there was some kind of fail-safe mechanism or early warning system in place.
Yeah, you would, but you'd be wrong. If the pumps malfunction, the tanks overflow. That pretty much sums it up.
Oh, pay attention to that pump.
Good day to you, sir.
Tell me you didn't forget this out of the
portion. Okay. I didn't forget the asado torch, Miguel.
But you did, though. Didn't you, Pablo?
Why do you have the Yates?
Dal is nothing if not unpredictable.
Marge read her file, of course. Her parents were political. Fought on the side of the junta. And Tamara always was a firebrand. Still, talk about wasted energy. Well, you'll be happy to know.
47?
It's done. Now what?
Now, we strike at the heart.
Edwards. You know how to find him, don't you?
Why, Edwards finds you, 47. He is untraceable, and he never lets you forget it. He is cocky, and that will be his downfall.
What's the plan?
Too many eyes. Meet me at the Olive Grove at sunset. One last tango, 47. How did you know?
Your deal. That kind of power always comes with a price. What's yours?
I think you know. I am sorry. This is a necessary evil.
What have you done?
Ether Brand's neurotoxin transfers by touch. See, Edwards learns by his mistakes, 47. And as you've clearly demonstrated, brute force is futile. It had to be me. It was the only way.
To get this close.
My family. I know what you did. After all these years, I finally know.
I am sorry.
You didn't have a choice. I did. Providence used you, but I'm no better. All I saw was a blank slate, a weapon to wield. I told myself it was what you needed, but people aren't meant to be controlled. This is a kindness. Goodbye, Agent. Are you still here? Still clinging on to your self-image. Agent 47, the apex predator. Always hiding behind the headlines. Was perfection its own justification? Or a willful distraction? A wall built contract by contract. To shield you from the uncomfortable truth. You're exactly the tool they bred you to be. Quite a piece of work you are. How could you possibly function on your own? You never even had a name. Until I gave you one.
That's him. Burnwood never ceases to surprise me. You really are a most singular individual. And to think, she wanted me to put you down. Lucky for you, I never throw away anything useful. Prepare the serum. Forgetting's not so bad. You've done it before.
What's he doing? Is he still looking at us?
I'm afraid so. Poor sap just won't accept his days are done.
Perhaps I should take him out to the woods and set him free.
Oh, it's a classic.
He was a loyal tool. But everything goes the way of the horse and cart eventually.
I couldn't agree more.
Are you done? The toxins are playing into your fears. Don't let them. Come on. Gotta get your head straight.
She wants me dead.
She has every right to after what we did. But that's not what is really going on.
She chose power. In the end, she was just like them.
No. She found a way to turn Edward's own cleverness against him. The rest is up to you.
I don't know how.
You do know. Once you dispose of Edwards, I will dismantle Providence from the top down. It will finally be over. All you have to do is embrace the past.